guys, welcome into the Poker Reborn channel. We are back with another tournament. This is the fifth tournament in this edition. And in this tournament, we have ourselves Destiny Orange, Forant, King Gang, and Medieval Cyborg. And I'm joined again today with Shinobi.
Oh, it's going to be a hell of a fight today, Pogo.
Hell yes, it will. And also, guys, we have a slew of analysts today, which is phenomenal. We got ourselves Baba, Mr. Meepo, Pogo Redemption, and Sober Jan behind the scenes working on each one of these guys. We're going to try to give you better updates as we go. With that being said, let's go into the wheel. Shinobi, go ahead and spin it.
Please.
What will it be? Beast Slayers!
Oh. Yes!
You know that I was hoping it was deserved.
How did you know?
That was
the
wild.
The only version I haven't played is Beast Slayers.
Alright, so now with Beast Slayers out of the way, guys, you can see on the screen everybody's set up and ready to go, so we're gonna go in 3, 2, 1, fight! And as you can see, they are out and about and ready to rock.
And with this Beast Slayer's origin, I got a question. Are crowns finally going to be an issue for our competitors? They're not going to be rolling in the dough here.
This is very true. I'm very, yes. Not only that, they're already starting a little injured. And actually, it's not so bad looking at it right now. Really, the only injury that they ended up starting with is a cut ear. That's initiative loss. Not the biggest deal in the world. But Shinobi, why don't you talk to us about the Beast Slayers?
Beast Slayers is one of the most tricky origins I've found. Nobody likes you, everybody's smelly, but they all need you. So you can earn a little bit on the crowns department. Renown shouldn't be an issue if you're going out and doing what these guys do best, hunting and killing the denizens of this world that look to prey on the peasants that you seek to protect.
Right. Yeah, I mean, really, for the Beast Slayers here, of course, with the origin, you have yourself a debuff to, however you want to say it. You have a 10% negative on your trading and selling. So that's going to be pretty big, honestly, looking at some of the prices. It's going to be a bit of a challenge to start looking straight up at, who do we got in this corner? Destiny Orange on this. He was just looking at some of the prices. And it will actually go over here to Forant, and he stopped looking at the prices. So, I can't really check out the prices because they're moving.
Stop also.
Yeah, so it's kind of a wild deal here, but ultimately, guys, they're coming out. They're starting out a little bit wounded. They are not in a great morale, so you're going to deal with that. As you can see right off the bat, we have a few Dire Wolves. They're going to jump. I mean, we got Destiny Orange going straight into the madness here against these Dire Wolves. How they handle this is going to be huge. This is the very dangerous fight.
Very dangerous fight, you know. But I got to say, with the brave iron-jawed brother that they have, hopefully at least they've got a runaway character.
Oh, we'll have to see what ends up happening, of course. But yeah, it's definitely a dangerous fight that commences here when we do this. When you're taking on three of these guys, and unfortunately his archer. With barely next to none to no armor is facing him down right now, so that's a crazy deal.
King Gang got into a direwolf fight too out of the gate with his caravan mission, so seems to be going a little bit better for him.
Oh yeah, well, and unfortunately here I really have a bad feeling about Destiny Orange. He might have to do a restart right off the bat, which is really unfortunate. But let's just kind of, I'm going to hold up. We're going to keep watching Destiny Orange because I'm curious. He did kill one of them. That's huge. He did drop the dog out. He's just got to get those morale checks. That's going to make all the difference. The dog being in the way. Ooh.
This is rough.
It's tough. It's there a tough one. And unfortunately.
Yeah, I got to say, at least it was the first battle. At least it was the first battle, so we can get back on the horse and out of the gate right away.
Right, right. Yeah, this is not that big of a deal, if we're being completely honest. So he's going to be out. We're going to let that one go. I do want to look down here at King Gang. He ended up taking it on no problem. Big reason for that, though, is ultimately the caravan ride, being able to help more numbers. It's just one of those things. He used the caravan, obviously, to his advantage. Very smart tactics by King Gang. Let's look over here, though. We have ourselves Forant, and all of his party members are just running.
No.
Like, he went... Oh, man. So, good and bad taken from this one right here. Of course, another...
early game, fearsome at its best.
Yep, and that is the problem. I mean, this is one hell of a fight to be jumping into. And I almost would rather just... it's best to just restart right from here. So we have two guys that are ultimately going to start with a -4. Unfortunately, that's just how it goes. Welcome to Battle Brothers. Welcome to the tournament. You know? Oh, my goodness. But... so yeah,
I'm sure that everybody watching has been in exactly the same spot that 4AM was just in.
No doubt.
Four of them, no problem. I can take them. Oh, one flag, no problem. Oh, everybody's fleeing. Not good.
Right. I am questioning here. I don't know if 4AM has the right map seed.
He changed his map seed.
Yeah. Do you want to give him a shout out? Actually, whoever's watching 4AM right now, if you could give him a shout out and let him know he needs to jump in and get the correct seed. So, but with that, oh, I think he's got it right here.
He noticed.
Perfect. All right. So with that being said, I want to go a little bit more in because we had a lot of hot and heavy action right there. So why don't we jump into more talking about the Beast Slayers run? You know, I think this is one of those ones that it's, would you actually take the time to focus on some beasts or use that to your advantage with, buying and selling, or how would you, if you were jumping into this tournament, how would you have handled this so far?
Jumping into the tournament right now with this origin start, the only thing that I see my mindset being is I'm going to get less gold. I need to complete more missions to bolster my crowns rather than hunting, killing, or trading, which I like to do in my casual plays. You know, I love being a trader. I love buying low, selling high when you can do that, when you get a good relation built up. But in an hour and a half, probably not a whole lot of that you're going to do anyway.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think for me, when I do the Beast Slayers run, I definitely try to focus on getting more brothers. Obviously, that just compacting the brothers and getting them ready. Using the gear to the best ability. I mean, you start out with the Triton. What is it called? Not the Triton.
The Warfork.
The Warfork, yeah. So using that to your advantage is going to be huge as well, because you can still use it in a sticky situation. You look at... right now I'm looking at... who do we got here? We got Kingang on the screen. He's using the Spear Wall tactic. He has a guy who can use Spear Wall with this thing. I mean, this is a great strategy, and it forces them because they don't have an archer, and he does. So definitely, these are the type of tactics you really want to go into with... the Beast Slayer run. Definitely one of my favorites personally, but yeah, in terms of a long game play, obviously that's where you get the most out of Beast Slayers. But in terms of early on, you know, like you were saying, you really want to utilize getting the best... oh, nice headshot. Two headshots.
Nice.
How about that?
Wow.
That's perfect. So he might even get the clothing for that. Get these guys out of the rags to riches, right? But
heck yeah. So
yeah, but go ahead. Yep,
I just wanted to say that Destiny Orange ran into those four ancient undead.
Oh my goodness.
On his start that ended 4AM's first run.
Yeah. He is utilizing these spears, but man, this is a... he's got dog out. I mean, he's going all in on this. This might work to his advantage with those shields. This is, again, rags to riches. You're going to take on these enemies, get the better weapons, get better helms. Huge. I mean, this is huge in terms of the helms situation. But it's a matter of what is going to happen. I do want to check real quick. I'm going to hold them up there real quick. But it looks like Kingang is doing just fine. He's just packed up in his group. He's getting these kills. Morale checks are starting to happen. But Medieval Cyborg, we haven't said anything about him. He is laying waste to these brigands here.
Yeah, this man is not only a fantastic first-time analyst, but he is really bringing the heat in his first tournament showing.
And way to be, for sure. And taking the forest to your advantage as well is going to be huge. Okay, so guys, we've gone over five. We're getting into the fifth tournament. I do want to say this for the purposes of other people seeing this, guys. If you're watching from Reddit, please upvote this. If you're watching it live right now, please hit that like. Subscribe to the channel for more stuff like this. This is a Battle Brothers centric, centralized channel. So you're going to see a lot of this stuff, guys. If you want to be a part of the tournament, please join us. Join the Discord. It's in the description below. Be a part of this. Guys, we have some big things coming. This is not the end. It's not going to be just early play. It's not going to be just veteran play. We're talking like setting everybody at 100 days, and setting all the equipment up, and everybody takes the save file and then jumps in. We got a lot of plans here on the Pugger Reborn channel, so come on out, join us, get to meet some of the guys, be a part of the behind the scenes stuff too. It's very rewarding. And also, if you do end up talking, if you do have a favorite YouTuber and they play Battle Brothers, get them in here. We've already had Twitch guys, a bunch of Twitch guys jump in. Now we're trying to keep broadening the horizons. Let's get that rocking and rolling.
Guys, yeah. get on this rocket ship and help us take the Battle Brothers esport to the moon. We're having a good time. Everybody loves it.
All right. It's not just stocks, guys. It's not just stocks. It's Battle Brothers. This game is only going to get better, and it is our goal to make that happen. So, yeah. So moving on with everything here, with just what's being said, Destiny Orange took down that fight, won it all. He got three of those freaking helms. He got better weapons. Man, Destiny Orange, let's be real here, man.
He's getting it.
He is getting it.
That's a great restart.
It's incredible. And he's just flying right now. He's just moving up. Moving on up, he's going north. Meanwhile, we have ourselves Forant, he's going south.
And that looks like trouble. That is a rough fight for anybody, day one, day two. I don't care who you are. These nomads, they're pocket sand, they fight dirty. I mean, I hope he uses these nets to his advantage, catches a couple of them back there so he can isolate them and take on the few that get to move forward into his line.
Oh, dude, for sure. This definitely can be dangerous, but luckily, too, you have yourself some weapons that are very desirable. Getting those spears, getting that Sav, the Sav being able to cut people open, especially early game, is going to be huge. And as you can see, he's using the caravan to his advantage as well. He's kind of pushing his guys forward. That's part of the tournament, guys. It's just risk-reward, right? So.
That's right. I got to say, though, I would love to see these guys put that bow down. As devastating as it is this early game, you just don't have the ranged attack to make it super effective. I mean, you get lucky here and there, like we saw with our double headshots down with King Aang. But a crossbow would be much more efficient. Javelins would be better at this stage. Just put the bow down for now. It's a lesson I learned the hard way.
Yeah, no, it definitely can be a hindrance more than a positive action that you take. But for what it's worth, if they're up on the line, maybe that's where you're getting the most, right? Because if you're aim shot, you can get that extra percentage to hit. But again, you're spraying and praying across the map, and I don't know if that's exactly the best way. I do want to say real quick, Medieval Cyborg, I was watching him just a second ago. He has torn this little encampment apart. He absolutely just pulled them from the encampment and just wrecked them. He just got a brother to join him on top of that. So he is just rocking and rolling. He's getting the stats. Then we have ourselves once again, Forant. Forant is, the caravan hands are actually jumping in and causing a little bit of havoc. Now with them running, that's huge. Oh, that wasn't too good though. One of the caravan hands just got his head lobbed off.
But he has really done a really good job at keeping these nomads where he wants them to be in this fight and really sticking it to them, hitting them in the morale where it hurts.
Definitely. And ooh, so close to getting those kills. Now, the only thing here would be the Noxzeers. As you can see, man, I didn't even get a chance.
Destiny. He put the helmets on and he got fearsome himself. Look at that.
He's going ham. He's hamming them. He is cutting them up and making a ham sandwich, okay? And eating it in front of everybody. Man.
Made these nachos look like curtain jerkers.
Oh my gosh. Beautiful strategies, beautiful everything. I mean, he's upgraded. He's got the war fork. I can't think of the name of it. It's the Triton. Whatever you want to say that. Either way.
Septum? Is that what it is?
Septum. Yeah, I think you're right. Yep, septum. So the septum here, he's using that. He's got the war fork, and he's doing his thing. He's going to be fine. I don't see a problem right now. The fact that he got the armor that he did is great. Now, Kin Gang has been a little silent for a hot minute, but we are back, and he does have two thugs with the two-handed axe. So that this could be a dangerous one. I think he's got better gear, obviously across the board. He's got better gear.
If I was him, I would just put that spear wall up and try to protect my shields from those axes. Mm-hmm. You know, let my archer do work. Look at that.
This is, I don't know, Shinobi, if we're talking out of pure luck or whatever you want to say, it's working out for him. If it ain't broken, don't fix it, right? That's kind of the lesson right now. Oh, man. He's getting headshot after headshot on top of that. Like, literally, they're running in and popping themselves in the face. It's beautiful. It's a beautiful sight. Battle Brothers to the extreme. Just a beautiful sight.
It just goes to show you how fickle this game can be. I'm looking at four screens, watching the RNG treat four guys four different ways.
Oh, and he just got another one shot with the archer. I don't know. You know, and here's the big thing, guys. By the way, we have Forant on the top right here. He's facing more. He just got attacked again, but these caravan hands are ready to make work. So we'll just kind of keep an eye on this, obviously.
He got a couple shields out of the last fight. He's in pretty good shape here.
Yeah, if he can get a few more shields.
Oh, archers just put more arrows into him. Yep. Whatever. I don't know what I'm talking about. Keep the damn bow.
Yeah, who cares at this point? But that begs the strategy. What do you do with your perks? You know, you got a guy with a bow. Are you going to use one of the things like fast adaptation is a great early starting perk, at least for this type of tournament, being able to get those extra shots in with this archer here. You're negating some of the issues of shooting twice, of course. So I don't know. It's going to be interesting to see how these guys are playing this out. I do want to look over here at Destiny Orange for a moment here. Now, he is in the crevice. He is in the butt crack of the hills. And
you did just headshot one of the thugs, though, over a shield with his septum. Oh.
Yeah, you just don't want to get caught with a guy by himself where three guys can surround, four guys can surround. You know, it's very possible. As much as the pickaxe isn't the worst thing in the world, it still is a very dangerous weapon. You're talking taking out the armor and having to rebuild that over time. You don't get the most days in the world to be able to do this, but it's a dangerous situation. I don't know.
Very dangerous situation. Pickaxe to the head. Nobody likes that.
And actually, he's got a guy right now in the middle. He's got the one guy. He got hit two times. He's happy as piss, you know, which is nice, but man, what a dangerous situation. I think he's starting to feel it a little bit. Ooh, and so there goes more armor. This is the missing shot. Do we see a turn? Do we see a turn here? That's the question.
I don't know. I definitely, there we go. Mm-hmm. That'll relieve a little bit of this pressure. Yeah.
All right, I will say, looking at, I don't want to move too far away, but looking at Forant on the top right here, he is laying waste to those guys, so we won't give that too much attention. We'll go back to Destiny Orange because it's more of a pivotal fight. But again, Forant is rocking against those desert nomads, so.
Just taking them down with ease, it's pretty great to watch.
Yeah. Oh, man, I'm just
there goes another one.
Oh, is he gonna? Okay, good. So there goes the morale check, and that is the change. He's just got to hold the one guy on the north side there. If he can avoid those hits, one, two. That's huge. So he's gonna have two shots for sure with the warfork and the septum. So we'll look to that. Also being able to hit these guys. This is gonna be a wrap. What a beautiful situation. There it is, and he is fine. He's going to be just fine. He didn't lose anybody. He did take some damage, lost some armor, but that is the name of the game. Let's see. We'll kind of look back at Forant.
What a great turnaround there was to that fight up there, man.
It is. You know, and did Destiny Orange started over, didn't he?
Yes. Yeah, he had one restart already.
So we have a restart from Forant, and we have a restart from Destiny Orange. Now, Destiny Orange is coming back in a snowball effect where he knew, hey, you know, I'm behind the gun already. Maybe I work on kills. Maybe I work on taking on, like, the Ancient Undead. He took on the Ancient Undead. He has better gear for it. His guys overall are much more improved and has a great chance to compete with these other guys in the tournament. Then you have yourself Forant, who, yeah, he's taking his time with these caravans, but he's racking up kills left and right. These guys, I mean, he's chasing these guys down, trying to get everything he can. It's a beautiful sight, honestly. So
it is. The way that both of these guys have come back with a vim and vigor, I wish that our competitors could come into the tournament and look at how many of them, after they've gone out, have turned around and either taken first or competed for first.
Mm-hmm. Well, 100%.
Or would have had it had they not had that negative 4 points. Just, it's so crazy to see how it wakes some of these guys up to take that negative 4 and lights that fire.
Right. I think, like, another interesting thing, I want to actually look down real quick at, we got a very, very interesting fight with Medieval Cyborg. So he, from what I can see, there's for sure one raider in this fight, and he does have throwing axes, or throwing javelins. Now, we've seen throwing javelins, and they are devastating. This is such a great map to be using, or not a great map, a great tournament for javelins, of course, because you're getting a better chance to hit. Now, it's a matter of what that raider does, because while it is a raider, and some people might say, well, it's only a raider, not that big of a deal. We're using guys that are not outfitted, that are not up on skill. This is going to be strategy, much strategy to actually make this work to his favor.
Well, you know, at least the dog didn't go down there. That's going to be a big help keeping those two tied up over there. And just, he's already absorbed 3-4 attacks. You're really seeing Cyborg shine very nicely here with the way that he's set up. The Raider is always going to be a problem, but if he can get at least 2 or 3 more of these thugs down, that Raider's morale is going to start getting shaky. You're going to get him to break.
Yep, and that is the name of the game there. We'll come back to him in just a second here. He is getting some nice shots off, and that looks like that might be just it. And then if he can dag him down too, that'll be awesome. Looking at King Gang, he's finally getting into another fight. This guy has been slow and steady winning the race. We were just talking about this before the fight, or before the competition here. He's got the gear. He's got the bros. He just needs to finish strong. And I think that this is a guy who can definitely do it without a doubt. I don't think this is a tough fight for him, but they did breach his wall, and there are guys kind of wavering a little bit. I think it'll be fine, but yeah.
Let me throw in that Destiny, Orange, and King Ang have been the two guys that have come to me the most in the week leading up to their tournament for practice runs. I did 3 with each of them, and honestly, I think that they only were separate one time. They were both doing practice runs together, like against each other.
Oh, wow. Yeah. So, guys, another thing, too, if you are worried about these tournaments, come on in. Shinobi's during the week and whatnot, he does the setups for guys to practice. Please, just give it a shot. I know how we tried getting these first 5 tournaments. These guys that have already competed, they have been messaging us like crazy. They've been talking to us, hey, when are we going to get to fight again? When are we going to do? They want to get back in these tournaments. But we want to broaden our horizons, get more guys involved. I just saw this real quick. King Gang just lost a brother, and he's starting to get some beatings here. The Archer
That's
doing work. His MVP is definitely the Archer, though.
we got to be getting close to that half an hour mark. I'd hate to see him go.
Yep, we're at 20 minutes right now. So, man, this is again. I think he'll be fine. The morale checks are happening. One more kill. I think he'll be fine. Oh, backliner dodging like crazy. Oh, but throw that dog out. Throw that dog out. There you go. Get that dog out there.
And mind you, guys, they can't hear us talking. The commentary is something that they have to wait to hear when they go back and rewatch their tournament run.
Yep, exactly.
We seem psychic a lot, but we look like fools a lot, too. It's just the way the game goes.
Oh, yeah, we can't predict them all, but hey, you know, it's fun trying, so... Okay, so now we got ourselves. So real quick, we have Medieval Cyborg. He won that fight, no problem. He didn't take any damage.
Got the javelins.
Yep. Then you got yourself Kin Gang. He ended up winning this fight. He did lose a brother, which is super unfortunate. But I think he'll be fine. He did end up retaining the armor that he had. Now the big fight right now, as you can see, he's bum rushing Foran.
Oh my goodness.
Now this is nuts.
Undead nomads with a necro. Just, you know, we saw Bravo Wolf fall prey to a necro trap in his run. I don't like necros in this tournament. I don't think it's worth the trouble.
You know, my only counter to it is look at the weapons, look at the gear, and look at how many there are total. You have yourself. If he can get one runner and hit that necro necromancer. Or if you could just shoot him, because apparently that's just how it goes. But if he can bog these guys down, let's see if he knocks them out. No, he got some headshots on him. But either way, the dangers are still here, no doubt. These guys are going to be... This is a dangerous fight. But if he can get to that necromancer, oof. Yeah, that's the fear right there. That boost from being able to take three shots on the with these zombies is just... It's nasty. But he's got to get a runner on that necromancer. This is just wild. Oh, no, he's... Oh,
tied his last brother up.
I'm not going to lie, this is a very, very scary situation. Man, I really feel he's lucky for dying right there. Holy cow. Beautiful situation. Either way, when you're watching this, he's missing. It's going to be interesting to see. I want to look and see what else is going on. We do have Destiny Orange facing a few of these hyenas. There's one of them breaking. We have ourselves the one of them trying to go around. Whatever he does, hopefully he doesn't lose that archer. It's not hard. They're very, they're very good at getting around these guys. But he does have a better chance of actually getting the pelts and stuff, which is great selling power.
Great selling power. And, you can't shake a stick at plus 15 initiative this early on either.
Mm-hmm. So it looks like Destiny Orange is going to be just fine. Yeah, he's going to be fine. What am I even talking about? We do have this massive battle. Not massive, but it's a bigger battle for this type of tournament, at least. He has nine enemies. He does have the caravan. Oh, he's using the caravan. Ah, so he's using the caravan to take these out. Okay, fair enough. It's a very good, very, very good setup. He's done that already once. It's so just a really effective strategy, What do you say?
Right, and with these guys dancing around the south the way they are, I gotta think we're gonna see some arena action at some point.
Definitely. I think you're right. Looks like so the fight with Four Ants is over. Beautiful. He did get the Sav, or he, not the Sav. Was it the Sav? No. That's the
Scimitar.
Scimitar, yes. So he has the Scimitar. He's heading south. Things are great. Things are looking pretty good. Obviously, again, we'll look at Medieval Cyborg. He is just laying waste to these guys. Beautiful strategies. Keeping himself rolling.
I am a big fan of the Scimitar in this game. It was a great addition. It's got the, a little bit more punch to it than your short sword. Still gives you the attack of a cleaver. It's a nice tool to have in your back pocket.
Yeah, causing injuries is so big. It's a very effective way early game when you're facing thugs and so on and just cutting people up. Just seeing the meat peel off the bone is a definitely fun in the Battle Brother setting.
Speaking of that, everybody, you should check out the Crippling Strikes roundtable and perk guide. It's a fantastic one.
Oh yeah, if you guys do want, we are doing it slow. It's a slow process, guys. I'm a one-man army in terms of the editing and stuff, so it is kind of it takes time to get those out there, but rest assured it is coming. More perk guides are coming this week that you're watching this. I've been working on one. The next one would be Bullseye, so stay tuned for that. It's awesome, guys. I'm gonna try to do all I can to get this game farther on the map than it already is. So, and if you are a YouTuber, you are watching this, if you do join the tournament, I will give the exposure to that YouTuber. You will be recognized at least, so hopefully it'll help with your channel too. Again, it's about getting the community together and bringing Battle Brothers to a whole new level.
Hey, I don't know about you, Puggo, but this is my favorite video game of all time, and I've been playing video games for over 30 years.
Yeah, you know this is my favorite. Come on now. And if it isn't, well then, I don't know, I'm insane is what that means.
Yeah, so, yeah, if it's not, put a lot of effort into it.
Yeah. So, I do want to say real quick with Kin Gang, he just is keeping his little six-man army. I don't know if he's going for the long-term effects of leveling or what the case may be. We're going to find out a little more in a little bit here. In about less than five minutes here, we're going to be going into the analyst. We're going to be talking to all four guys, kind of getting a beat on what's going on with their brothers. So,
And I can't wait. We've actually got four guys, so we should get eyes on everything. A lot of good numbers. Maybe some insight into the strategies that they've seen that we've missed covering the four guys rather than just one. Really excited for this new one.
Oh yeah, it's gonna be good. Right now we do have, man, we got fights all the way across the board here. A lot of the southern fights, this is a sign, guys. If you guys have been watching, you know that the arena has been neglected. In this last tournament, Soberjan was the first and only person to complete the tournament, on top of that doing two. So there are records to be placed here. If you do end up beating a tournament so many times, you go in the record books as this guy has done this the most. We will do update videos talking about the tournament as a whole over the last five. And yeah, we'll be hosted by Shinobi and I.
Yeah, I really can't wait for that. You and I are going to sit down. We're going to have to rewatch some of the tournaments, write down some of our favorite moments, highlights, maybe things that we missed when we were watching live. It's going to be a lot of work, but gosh, is it going to be great.
Oh, for sure. One thing, Shinobi. We didn't bring this up before, guys. It has been neglected, but Shinobi, remember the first tournament? There was something with fists? I don't know. Something like that.
Oh, you know, so... We you had a bunch of brothers lined up there on Despicable Dick's side, and a lot of action going on the floor. And I think you got really excited. You just watched a wolf fall over, and when I was watching it back, that was definitely a dagger. It's definitely a dagger that killed that wolf. So Dick, reputable Richard, I hate to do it to you, buddy, but we're gonna have to take that one back. That's our bad.
Yeah, it was really hard to find. He was behind. There was a guy, a brother in front of him, and you could barely see, but it was a little butter knife sitting in his guy's hand. So the dagger, the first punch kill has not been established just yet. Looking at some of the things going on right now, guys, looking at King Gang, these enemies, the AI has spread itself out and thrown him for a loop. He is surrounded.
Oh, man, but his archer just keeps coming in.
Oh yeah, he's the man.
He's clutch.
He is clutch as all get out, just tearing these guys up. It's unbelievable. I love it. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to do. I mean, if you're gonna pick something out of luck, that's a good way to go about it. Being able to pick two guys off headshots, pick off guys left and right with headshots. He doesn't even have a headhunter, and he's doing what he's doing. Beautiful, beautiful situation. I think he's gonna be all right.
He's got a hood up. He doesn't even have any peripheral vision.
Right. Pretty much, but yeah, I and there he goes. Oh my gosh, what the hell? Well, this is gonna be something to definitely bring up. King Gang and his archer is the King Archer, man. He's got a master archer this early on. Looking at some of the other fights across the board again, you have Forehand. Forehand is taking a very interesting stance. He's pulling enemies into this caravan and having the armies of the South cause havoc with these guys.
It's like he is just waging a one-man war on the homeless population of the southern city states.
Right. Unbelievable. Oh, we have our... That's funny. Medieval Cyborg was just looking at a... He was looking at a hedge knight. Things we wish this early on. What a beautiful setup. Maybe one of these times he'll get in the lone wolf run and see how much he loves it. So, who knows, right? Well, looking across the board, I think everybody is pretty well settled. There is a more dangerous fight for Destiny Orange, but his guys are so well set up. His comeback has been so impressive, of course. He's got the brothers. Between the numbers, the equipment, and everything in between, I think he's going to be just fine.
I mean, I got to say, you know, Pugo, I'm kind of leaning towards one of these guys being Rock Prime 2 Electric Boogaloo and taking this tournament after a restart.
It's possible. Very possible. You got two really strong combatants on the top side here between Forant and Destiny Orange. But I feel like everybody is really starting to come into form. At first, I thought, man, having two guys go out right off the bat, that's ugly. But those two guys are getting work. So with that being said, guys, or go ahead. Yep.
King Ang's got a brother there that he picked up to replace the man that died. 3 stars in melee attack, 2 stars in ranged attack.
Yeah.
Let's just hope he adds some numbers so he can keep these key guys alive.
Right. Well, hey, so with that being said, guys, we are going to unmute these other guys here. We're going to get into the first break here and talk with these guys, see what's going on. So they're all in here right now. So why don't we start right down the line? We'll go with Baba. Baba, so what's the stats? What are we looking at?
So basically, King Ang, he has around 27 kills. He has 1,000 gold. Hasn't finished any ambitions. He has 7 days, 11 levels, 6 brothers, and 4 settlements. And I think I wish he would be more aggressive in his playstyle. I mean, that's just me, but he's been taking his fights very carefully. Like, there was one chance he had to go into a fight with Brigands and Noxerish, but he didn't take it. I mean, that was probably a smart move. But he's been very careful. He's been shield walling a lot, like a bit too much, I think. He's been wasting a lot of stamina. But it's going fine for him. His archer has been carrying him, though.
Yeah, that's what we've been talking about the whole time, that damn archer.
Yeah, the master archer plan, it's working, though. I mean,
yeah. I just hear it cheering.
Yeah,
every time I get the kill, it helps me with my analytics.
Right, no doubt. So that'll be Kin Gang there. So why don't we let's bring in our next guy here. We're gonna go with Mr. Meepo. What do we got with your guy?
All right, we have Medieval Cyborg going in with an extremely aggressive, solid, economically, strategically. He's sitting on 29 kills and 10 brothers. He's also at 10 settlements and day number 12. And we have 10 brothers who are sitting on 14 levels.
Man. That's some
good
stuff.
That's pretty solid. That's a solid place to be sitting.
Yeah, he's tactically efficient. He's taking smart contracts. He's moving around the board. He has a lot of settlements already. He's on day 12. It's looking good. I'm impressed.
Yeah, I mean, I kind of look at that and I say, well, you know, if he's at 29 kills right now he's technically in combat. He's going against seven more enemies. But the point with it is, if he stays at that 29. He could, 29 kills, if he continues that out throughout the next hour, he's going to be about 90 kills when it's all said and done, just padding
that
it, so, yeah.
Would be crazy.
That is nuts. All right, well, then, with that, we're going to bring in Pugger Redemption. What do we got going on with your guy?
So, I've been looking at Forant, and he's been... Well, let's get it out of the bag. He was one of the ones who had an early mishap with some undead, and he ended up having to restart. However, I felt that he has actually rebounded really well. Part of that is he's been very fast trying to get in and out of towns, rush around the map. He's found 7 settlements already, and one of his big strategies was, in order to catch up in gear, he's been taking a lot of fights. And so his first thing he did when he came back in was gather up 10 brothers right off the bat, go in and get some fights done. He's sitting at 25 kills. And albeit his levels is actually kind of low, I think after this next battle that he's in, he's going to start popping off in levels. I think part of that was because he rushed and got a bunch of brothers, but he's only got 5 levels to his brothers right now. He has recycled a couple in his battles. Again, he's been fighting a lot with 25 kills. But otherwise, yeah, I think one of the key advantages he might try and pick up is he took a couple of caravan missions down south, and he's been in a lot of the southern cities, and he might look to do some arena battles at some point. So I'm looking forward to seeing if he goes that route. He's only on day 9, but... Again, he's been moving out, moving fast.
Mm. Yeah, you can definitely tell there's been a rebound, and a pretty hefty one at that. It's going to be really cool to see if he can kind of bring it together and get those guys the levels that really are needed, upgrading the equipment and everything in between. Shinobi, you got any thoughts on it?
Yeah, I would love to see him keep this momentum going. This has been one hell of a comeback, and hitting the arena would only elevate it to the next level if he could get a couple matches in there.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, for sure. Well, with that out of the way, then we got our last guy here, Soberjan. What do we got going on with your guy?
So the Destiny Orange is a great guy. Unluckily, he got wiped in the first minute, and I literally cried about it. But then he rebuilt greatly, and now he has 39 kills and 17 levels, I think. Although he's slow on days and towns, he has 5 towns and 6 days.
Oof. Did I hear that right? 39 kills?
Yeah, while you were talking.
Oh man,
good lord. Man, I was just hyping up the whole 29 kills a second ago. This guy continues. Ooh. He's going to be about 120. He's going to be a buck 20. So pretty much deadly efficient, huh?
Yeah, indeed. I love his playstyle. He uses a lot of meat, so he has 11 of brothers, and they are destroying everything.
That's perfect. Well, hey, that's the way to be. If you can continue that momentum. Again, the momentum. That seems to be the name of the game here right now. These guys are starting to steamroll, which is really amazing to see everybody going through that. For especially when you get two guys who ended up getting pretty much ousted right off the bat. So thank you, Sober Jan. I want to say thank you to everybody else that was able to make it to this. Of course, definitely awesome stuff. Shinobi, any final thoughts before we go into break?
Guys, great analysis. I appreciate all of you being here and everybody watching at home. You're the best.
Right on. All right, guys, we'll be back in just a sec.
Mr. Lion.
What, kid?
Do you need any help?
No.
Well, I just wanted you to know that I think you're the best ever.
Yeah, no shit.
But I just wanted to give you this potion.
Piss off, kid.
Well, f*** you too!
Hey, kid.
Alright guys, now that we're back, this is going to be the interesting part. Now the next 30 minutes we're going to go into the interviews and stuff as they get out of combat. So definitely worth seeing where they're at or how they're feeling. But Shinobi, like, holy crap. I mean, just...
Holy crap is right. Just the comeback kings right now.
Yeah.
Rock who?
Yeah, right? At this point, I mean, when I think about Destiny Orange, like... I'm sorry, 39 kills at the first 30-minute break? After a restart on top of that. I mean, and just how he's holding his guys together. I mean, what more can you ask for? Now, I will say, like, Forant's doing what he can to get this party rocking and rolling. He's doing just... I mean, he's right there. He's getting it figured out, too. Once he gets those levels rolling about, man...
He was like Batman down in the South running around fighting homeless people the way he was doing it. It was crazy.
Yeah. Now, I will say this is a very dangerous fight that he's gotten into. He is taking on what looks like 4 Raiders and 2 just looks like the Poachers and stuff. Now, while it may not be the biggest thing in the world, he did get a kill. That's really awesome. That's great. But that one Raider with the pike killing a guy. And now their morale goes up. It gets really dangerous. Now, of course, when he ends up doing the riposte, the things can go south, right? If he takes a shot at this guy, it could cause absolute mayhem. He's got to get some dudes on the back. Well, let's see if the archer's got it going on. Oh my gosh.
There it is.
Shinobi, I got to be honest with you, man. You made a mistake by saying don't use that.
I did. I sure did.
What the heck?
You know, that early on in the game, usually the bow is not going to work out for you. It doesn't work out for me. I just end up wasting a brother's fatigue every battle.
Right.
Here I am, a little bit of egg on my face, the way the RNG is. Nothing new with me in battle, brothers.
Well, it is what it is, right? So we do have our first Webneck or Webek or whatever. I know somebody's not going to like it. But
Webneck.
We got ourselves some of these there Webbers, the Webber's necks. But
some of them, they're big spitters.
But for real, look at some of these weapons, though, that he's dealing with, or he's got going on here. Destiny Orange, if he wasn't dangerous before, he's got a pike, he's got a spectrum, and he's got himself the Warfork. Guys, outfitted across the line. good freaking night. Let's go. Let's go. You know?
Spider blood all over him. He doesn't even care. Doesn't care. Yeah, doesn't care.
He's wrecking them. He's absolutely wrecking them. This is a fight that tore up Vincent when he Vinny the Nose. So Vinny the Nose, he took on this almost identical fight. However, he did have an egg sac within three tiles away, which is completely unheard of, right? But that thing was just pumping out spiders. So there is a difference here. But my goodness, looking at this, like he this isn't even a competition for these guys. And what, I don't know, man. I just, this is wild. We do have, I will say, real quick, Forant ended up winning his fight. And finally, we have Medieval Cyborg, a name that has been falling through the crevice of the earth, doing a great job, no doubt. But we just haven't heard a lot from him at this point. But looking at what he's taking on, the first barbarian fight.
Yeah, now it looks like he's going to go pick on the homeless people up north. Why don't you guys just leave them alone?
What?
Goodness gracious. Right. Take on some real challenges here.
Yeah, exposed just skin.
Stepping on the downtrodden left and right. Be more like Destiny Orange. Go after some beasts.
Yeah, I mean, if you think that's not a bear pelt on his head. That is one of the dogs that died, and it was his best friend. That's how desperate they get in the north. It gets cold up there, okay?
You know, he probably ate that dog, too.
To be fair.
Probably ate it. And then put him on for warmth. Like, that was man's best friend there for several years, at least.
Exactly. Another fight going on right now. We're looking at Kin Gang getting some work on his brothers, and he needs this so bad. He actually pulled a militia from a town going in after these, actually, a necromancer and a crap ton of freaking wiener gangers, this is definitely something.
This is something that if I was him, I'd be taking my ball, my bros, and go in the other direction. This fight is not gonna be worth it. What? Okay, you're gonna get a pitchfork, you're gonna get a few cleavers, a couple dog beaten clubs. Like, you're not gonna get anything to write Ma about.
Well, there's the you might get the armor. It's not pretty. Because ultimately, no. whatever they kill comes back to life. Remember, it's not dead until the douchebag in the far black, or the far back with all the black, goes down. That's the only way. So yeah, this is gonna be an interesting fight. This could really be the end of Kin Gang. I'm not saying it is, but we've seen a lot of bad things.
You know, they got their pitchforks out, Puggo. Where are the torches? You need torches for something like this. Pitchforks and torches when you get the town mob together.
I definitely would say that with that, then you gotta use, if we're gonna, we don't have any torches, but we do have ourselves some fire pots. And I gotta say, if we can use them, we gotta too. Unfortunately, he doesn't. And he did step on that brother's body. Best thing he could possibly do right now. He's gotta cover those, he's gotta put the rug over the dirt, right? Or put the rug under the, or the dirt under the rug. There we go. That's the saying. So we shall see. This is such a dangerous fight, though. I mean, I don't know. The militiamen, I get it. It's great, but they don't have a lot of armor. They don't have. They're not like the most skilled fellows in the world.
No, and I got to tell you, with all this risk, not even a biscuit there. I know you think the armor, but he's gonna pierce it. All of those pikes, knives, pitchforks, spears. That armor is going to be holier than the Pope.
Mm-hmm. You got, yeah, right. Forant taking on some guys in the desert. Still not really going crazy. He hasn't. I don't know if he found the arena just yet, but I gotta imagine he's working up to it. Some of these guys got to work up to it. It's definitely, if you're the only guy that gets it, those 3 points are so valuable. It could change everything. And for him, he did end up losing 4 points by having to restart, anyways, right? So this is a great opportunity. This is a huge opportunity for him, especially, to take that. If he can, there's not enough words to explain that. So
no, Forant has been nose to the grindstone since he got back on his horse right out the gate, taking on dangerous fight after dangerous fight after dangerous fight, and it's really worked out for him so far. He's down on his number of brothers, but goodness gracious, he's got some quality guys there now.
All right, I got to call out a douchebag of the tournament, and it's going to be Destiny Orange. He's got 300 men versus 3 right now, and they're all brigging losers. Let's just be real.
Yeah, right.
I mean, yeah, see, like, I don't even know. Like, this is just mean. This is cruel. This is cruel. It's a beautiful sight, but it's cruel. Oh. All right. Well, everything did pause here for a second, guys. This happens. My PC's got this. Randomly, it does this for a second. We will be back. Oh, things are happening. See, that is the name of the game here. We have these lapses.
For a moment.
Oh, there we go. All right, so PC did the thing, but he did wreck, and there goes the head. Perfect. All right, so now that we're back and everything's rocking again here, Kin Gang, what's going on down here? They're making a push. They're pushing. I mean, it looks like he will pull it out. I gotta imagine he's gonna make it, but it is still just a. I don't know. It looks like he's.
He's still got a slog ahead of him. Still got a slog ahead of him right now against those bodies that are just gonna keep coming back every turn.
Yeah, and as long as they keep falling too, like he's got some of the militia men that if they go down, it's gonna be ugly with the resurrections.
Yeah. And it's gonna wreak havoc on the morale of everybody that's, you know, still got a pulse minus the necromancer.
Mm-hmm. You know, it's interesting. Have you noticed, like, Foran's making a big push on these kills, though? Like, he's just laying waste to these guys. I mean, every time I look up, we've got some kind of action going on in the top right.
But at what cost right now? He just lost another brother.
I seen that.
Put him at total.
Yeah, that's
8.
That's a tough one. That is actually, that's a pretty tough one. Well, as long as he keeps rocking and rolling, it does. The only issue I see there is the fact that he's losing levels and a brother. Those are two metrics out the window, guys. Mind you, guys, if you don't know the rules and stuff, I know I've had this question a few times. I'm going to put it in the description section below so you can check it out there. Otherwise, if you want to come over to Discord, guys, you can be a part of this, like I say, definitely worth doing. We've been rocking and rolling, and we need to do some interviews. So.
Heck yeah.
Well, let's
get Medieval Cyborging.
Yeah, we can.
He's not doing anything?
Yep, let's go with that. We'll make that one work. So, all right. Medieval Cyborg. I see you're traveling the lands right now, man. How is it going? How's everything transpiring for you?
It's okay so far. I was planning on playing really safe, and I haven't lost anyone yet. So, if I might be falling behind in other categories, but I'm hoping that the other people will, like, lose brothers and I'll catch up that way.
Right. Well, yeah. I mean, at this point, like I say, you're really sticking to a game, and I think it's like. We see it. We can definitely see it. You're at 20 days, and we're coming up on the hour mark. So, I mean, hey, keep pushing it, man. I think everything's going pretty well. You have a lot of selling goods right there as well. Like, man, I don't see much of a problem. Any things you're looking towards in the goal of the next, like, 40 minutes? What are you looking to accomplish?
Just explore and maybe do an arena to secure at least, you know, a placement in that.
Yeah.
That's generally. Just, you know, keep leveling, that kind of thing.
Right on. Shinobi, you got anything?
Good thoughts on hitting the arena up. Question for you. How has your archer been working out for you?
It's good. I haven't got as many levels as I would like, but I would really like to get, like, the hybridized, like, you know, fast hand thrower pikeman combos with fast adaptation, because the idea is, though, like, you can start attacking bandits from 4 tiles away, build up the fast adaptation stack, and switch to a pike weapon and be able to apply that even if they are missing.
There you go.
Sounds like a solid way to go. Thanks for your time, Medieval Cyborg.
Thank you.
Right on, man. We'll see you at the finish line. All right. So, here's the thing, guys. Again, there's a lot of metrics that go into this that you might say, well, the guy who's doing a speed run wins. Well, look at this guy. He's not exactly going after all the kills. He's got 11 brothers. He's pushing the days. He's at 22 days, not even at the hour mark. That is incredible. That is legit incredible. When you put it all down on the ground. It's, again, this is another tournament where it's going to be very hard to predict who wins. When you hear 39 kills from Destiny Orange, you think, wow, like, that's a lot of kills. Wow. But that's only one metric, right? So definitely something to keep in mind. Any thoughts, Shinobi?
Yeah, I just, you know, I'm going to ask everybody how their archer's doing.
Oh, yeah, you got to at this point. At this point, you pretty much have to.
Medieval Cyborg's taken an approach that I love seeing with all the, well, I guess not all. It was just a couple guys with pushback on the speedrun issue. It's not a speedrun. It's a timed play.
Right.
And he is taking a very safe approach that I think is going to pay off in those metrics that he's going for. Maybe not his total brothers, because these guys are kind of just swarming. But man, his levels have got to be second to none by the end of this. Mm. If he keeps all of these guys for the whole hour and a half, nobody's beating him there.
Right. Have you noticed too, so this fight is still going on, guys. Kin Gang is going to walk out of this with no problems. The win behind his, on his belt, pretty much. He's going to be doing just fine. He's going to be killing this necromancer, no problem here in just a second. But one hell of a ride in terms of having to take this fight on. Granted, you know, the way, if you're going to do it, you're going to want to do it with the militiamen. Definitely a way to go. But man, what a long slog of a fight. It's absolutely crazy.
It is. And the amount of time that it took up, who knows how many kills he's actually going to come out with. Who knows what kind of loot he's going to get to sell at a 10% worse price than normal. I just don't think it was worth all the time it ate up.
Yeah. Well, I want to actually see what happens with this fight for sure. I'd like to do one more interview before we go into the second break here. So let's just see. Let me just make sure. Oh, man. Oh, no. Have you seen Forant?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
I'm looking at that.
I listen, guys. I know that direwolves aren't the end of the world, but at this still point in the game, he's got the same amount of backlines as he does frontliners. But you're still exposed, and these guys take three shots. Ugly, ugly, ugly. That's the name of the game. And I don't know. We'll see. As long as he gets these kills, gets those solid strikes, he should be fine.
Gets that morale to break. Yep.
I want to see what Kin Gang ends up getting out of this fight, but we need to see this going on here. So I was hoping it would have happened already. All right. So I'm just gonna watch. We're gonna watch and see what happens here. This is too big, too pivotal of a fight, and so far it's looking good. I gotta hold my breath here. Didn't get a knockout there. He is going. Just get the morale checks. There we go. So what are we at here? So technically six with the one running away. We're just gonna pretty much discard him because him running away is the death sentence. So. Oh well, he's gonna use the archer to take him out. That's a dangerous.
King Ang finished his fight out.
He did end up finishing it out. Do you know what he got? Or...
Yeah, he got 89 crowns and 2 tools.
Oh my gosh, that is rough. Well, oh no. So the direwolves are striking back. They got one kill so far. Now, mind you, Forant's been riding the wave. Okay, he's been doing a great job here consolidating his brothers, getting those levels higher. Everything's been working really to his advantage. But with every time you lose a brother and you've been working on those certain brothers, it, like, one death is one brother. It could be 5 levels. That is, and oh, that's so rough. It's just such a dangerous scenario. Okay, there we go. So there's another one running. Oh, and another brother went down. Oh, Shinobi.
Oh, this is not looking good at all right now. Early game run enders.
Oh, no. What? Ah, this is getting interesting. I'm curious. Oh man, it's tough to even give commentary because it's just, guys, we don't wish the worst on these guys, but this is really ugly, and morale checks can get hot and heavy here in just a second. He loses one more guy, and it's ugly. It's really ugly.
Real ugly.
Because you see the morale checks across the board. Everything is morale. It has a morale check. Direwolves or brothers. Oh my goodness. Oh, he needs that hit so bad. That guy has failed him time and time again. The one's gonna run, which hopefully if he does get the kill... Oh, and he might rally. He might rally. Oh boy. I'm gonna back out real quick, see if other fights... No, this is definitely priority right now. So...
Destiny, weren't fighting some raiders.
Yeah, I seen that. Okay. I think he's gonna pull this one.
There it is. Yeah, come on.
Now he needs... There we go. Okay, so... Forehand just... Oh, and they won. Oh, they got one coming back. Oh.
Oh, no.
It's over. He calls it.
Yes.
Wow.
Get out of there.
Oh,
get out of there.
Yeah. Get out. Okay, so that was a that was a close battle. Why don't we get King Gang in here real quick, and then we'll go into break here. So we'll get that going here. Let me just... King Gang.
Yo.
How's it going, man? We see your... traveling the lands right now. You just got a little lucky right there with them deciding to run away. How you feeling, man? How's everything going for you?
Everything is going well.
Like
everything is going well so far.
Any like big progressions here that you're noticing with your group, or anything you're trying to strive for at the moment?
Well, right now I'm trying to strive for continuing survival, and I guess you guys just saw. Ooh, I just fulfilled an ambition.
Oh, that's huge.
Very nice.
But I guess you guys just saw the big battle with the undead where I dragged a militia into it.
Yes.
Yes, that.
I was about to
ask. How was your reward on that? Did you feel gratified with what you got?
I felt gratified because I got a lot of kills out of that, and the peasant militia made a great kill farm there.
Yeah.
Good.
Well, as long as you got what you wanted out of it, but we were looking at that going, yes, you pulled in the militia. But my goodness, between time and between just what could happen, unfortunate happened, how many brothers did you lose in that fight?
Zero.
Nice. Okay, well, okay.
I got out with only one guy taking a single hit.
Wow. Okay. Well, okay. Yeah, we need to just shut up on our end sometimes, because it just seemed like this was a fight that just could have gone south, because if they, with the militiamen, they didn't have a lot of armor, so if they go down, man, they go down. And then they'll just rise back up as the enemy. So, but
yeah.
Really good job though, man. It seems like a very solid run right now. And if you're feeling good about it, do you have anything you're striving for in the last 30 minutes here?
Oh, 30 minutes left?
Yep, 30 minutes left.
Ooh. I'm not sure. I just want to continue, make sure I don't end up dying. This is a bit. I've gotten some solid brothers in this run, so I might save right before the end before I sell off all the gear.
Right on. Anything, Shinobi, before we call it?
Not at all. Great job, man.
Right
Thank
on.
Thank you.
All right, man. Well, we'll see you at the finish
oh,
line.
Oh, wait. Your archer.
Oh, yeah, that's right. How did you forget? How did I forget?
How are you digging your archer?
Best archer. He's murdered so many people.
15 kills.
Oh, your archer.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, I'm so glad you thought of that. Like,
yeah.
Dude, I called it. I called it. You have the master archer, man. This guy right off the bat had two headshots right in your, I think it was your first battle or your second battle, and it was just like you set the tone with that stuff, man. Keep that boy alive. Yeah, it's just
That's
nasty.
The goal. He's doing amazing.
He is doing great. All right. All right, well, we'll call it there then, and we'll see you at the finish line.
See you at the finish line.
All right, yeah, that's just wild. Well, guys, with that being said, we're going to... I know Forant's got a big fight, but he's got a bunch of guys. I think he'd be all right. We'll see. But what we're going to do then, guys, we're going to go into the next break here. I'm going to bring in Baba Ganoush. Baba, what do we got going on with your guy?
Yeah, he hasn't made much progress. He's been wasting a lot of time. He's been retreating from battles, going into big battles, that's just wasting a lot of time. I didn't count the militia kills because it's technically not his kills, but if I did, it would be 16 extra kills. He got like one kill from that fight that he was just in. That's why he got so little loot. It's just, he's actually gone down in crowns quite a bit. Has around 700 crowns right now. He completed one ambition, as you saw. It's just been disappointing. Like, say the least. I thought he was doing very well in the beginning, but he's been slowing down a lot.
Really? So just so just in terms of consistency, what was the days that he's at again?
15.
15. Okay. So there's still competitive levels here to be had. It's a matter of, I wonder, like, when I did ask him about the metrics and stuff, he didn't really say that he had, like, a, you know, like an end game, right? Just making sure that he's able to sell off a bunch of stuff. So, I don't know. We'll have to see what happens. I mean, as long as he stays in the race.
Then also he had to decline the contract, so he lost a bunch of renown from that, which can hurt him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess we'll have to see. Shinobi, any thoughts?
Not at all. Good job, Baba.
Thank you.
All right. So with that, then, we'll go in with Mr. Meepo. What do we got with your guy here?
All right. Medieval Cyborg is staying on pace. His guys are getting better equipped. I just watched him mop up an arena battle. He has 2 ambitions. He's on 24 days, 11 bros, 21 levels, and 45 kills with another possible 13 on the way.
Oh, wow. Wait, so I missed the arena battle. I didn't even see that. So that must have happened. Must have just happened, or?
Yeah, just happened. Okay. He got out of it, got better equipment, and now he's fighting 13 brigands. He did retreat from an undead battle, but it was probably the smartest choice he could have made. He did not want to lose a brother.
Oh, at this point, at this stage, everything matters. You get to the last 30 minutes, you have to stay consistent. You have to keep your brothers on the top shelf. But you look at, like, even right now, he's got 3 javelins. And what a strat, though, right? I mean, it's just going to add to his final kills, I imagine. So, but you said 45 kills, is that right?
Yeah, he's at 45 kills, and when he started this battle, there's 13 of them. So he's at 46 kills, possible 12 to go.
Yeah, hey, pad those stats. You got to get him, maybe just even if he seals out a second place victory, because I don't know. We have to see what the other guys are, but this is definitely a good step in the right direction.
I have one more metric I'm kind of interested in. He's sitting on 15 settlements. I believe there's 16 settlements total, 16 to 20. I'm hoping he finds them all.
I did see. He's got everything going on for him. This is incredible. We'll just have to see. We'll have to see what happens, right? So, all right, cool. Well, I appreciate it. Shinobi, you got anything you want to add? Or?
Man, this guy just consistent going the whole way. Let's see if he can throw up some Gordon Comstock numbers, because it's kind of who I'm seeing signs of.
Right. All right. Well, let's go to our next guy then, Redemption. What do we got going on with your guy?
Just steady pacing from Forent. He actually just completed an ambition not long ago, so that might help him in the renown department. I didn't catch his goal. He's been in this fight with these webnecks for a long time now, but he's steadily chopping away at them. He's gonna really add to his kill score, which was at 40 or 54 prior to this fight. His, as you guys kind of mentioned, he had finished that fight after we last talked, and he had gotten a bunch of level ups, and actually that's been speeding along for him as time has gone on. That might change a little bit once we get to the end game. We can take a look at what exactly or who exactly lost in that fight against those direwolves. That might be something that might hurt him in the long run if he lost some really strong brothers. Otherwise, yeah, he's been flying around, still trying to stay around 10 brothers at all times. And then settlements, he hasn't expanded out as much, as well as he actually has been moving away from the south, which I was really hoping last time we talked. I thought he might try and go for arena battle, but he has not. But yeah, he's just been moving along at a steady pace, just taking on contracts, doing missions.
Well, with these webnecks, though, just adding, just padding that stat. How many kills you said again?
He's currently at 54 prior to this fight alone.
Yeah, this is going to be huge.
Webneck's going to be huge.
Yeah, guys, he's facing a bunch of webnecks, so that's gonna be awesome to see how that plays out. Shinobi, anything you want to add?
Man, I'm just really excited to see that these two came back with such a fury.
100%. All right, well, thank you, Redemption. And then finally, here we have ourselves, Soberjan. What do we got with your guy?
He's doing really great. He's heading north and he has 66 kills. It's a lot.
That's a lot. That is
and
a
now
lot.
He's fighting the webcast, so he will have even more.
Yeah. You just see, Puggo, do you see the parallels between these two guys up top?
It's wild, man. It's wild to see. You know, yeah, it's wild. What other stats
really
we got?
Was open. So he has 10 towns and 2,000 crowns. I was really hoping that he will go for Purina, but now he's heading south. Wait, no. So I think he's not going to take it.
Wow. You know,
he has got 12 brothers, and they're doing just fine. They're all alive for a long time, and he has got 24 levels. I think it's a lot.
My goodness. Man, I'll be honest with you guys. I think I know who is the front runner right now, but man, there is no doubt that there is some serious competition going on for probably even first, but mostly second and third place. Well, any of those places, because we just don't know when it's all said and done. But man, these guys, this guy here is, I mean, Orange is no joke. He is really trying to be the battlest of brothers, if you will. So, Shinobi, you want to add anything to that?
Every tournament we do, things just get a little bit crazier, don't they?
Every time. You just don't know. I love that it's getting more. I love seeing more competitiveness like this. This is a very, very competitive
group of fellas. Man, right. This is fantastic.
100%. So, all right, Soberjam, thank you so much. All right. Well, with that being said, guys, we're gonna go into break, and we will be right back to finish this out.
Grandpa, can you tell me a story about 2020?
Ah, 2020. A story of adventure, brotherhood, and the purest love. I joined a mercenary band that year. Lost my foot to the diabetes, although people did think it was the linworm. Finally, I ended up mugging the love of my life.
Huh?
Yeah, I f***ed that melon so f***ing hard.
Oh my god!
Yep, the town was pissed, but I corked that melon something fierce, and I regret nothing.
Grandpa, what the f***?
All right, guys, welcome back, and now we're gonna go into the final drive here. We had a lot of stuff going on in this last one, and then the analytics, of course. So we are pushing time, so we're gonna jump right in. We have to talk with Destiny Orange yet, and finally, Forint. Unfortunately, they're both in a battle. This we've been talking about it already. That Orange had been taking on these webnecks. There's a lot of dead webnecks, and look how much of this forest he has covered trying to kill these guys. And he just finished. Beautiful, beautiful thing. Shinobi, we're just gonna go in and talk to him right now while we got him, because he's just gonna get into another fight before long. It's just bound to happen. So all right, Destiny Orange, hey man, how's it going?
Hey, it's going pretty good.
Oh my gosh, man, you are just a demon out there, just slaying the land. You see it, it's dead. Like, you don't even play, man. I'm just
that's
saying.
That's how I roll, you know. You just gotta take every fight. No, it didn't work out the first battle, but since the first battle, I don't know if you guys saw that.
Oh yeah, yeah, we saw it. Yeah, you went out quick. But hey, you know what? For what it's worth, if you go out right away and you come back in, man, you're still right there.
Yeah, it was good then, but you know, I thought about it for a second. I was like, okay, this is probably not a good battle. I tried to run away, but then it was too late. The Darvels already caught me.
Right.
No, since then, you know, I've been feeling great. If only I could, do this well without having to restart.
Yeah.
You know, that's something I mentioned.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I noticed for the practice runs, you know, the same thing was happening, you know, like, I'd restart and then do really well. So I'll have to work on that for in the future.
Yeah. Well, I mean, for what it's worth, though, I mean, you've handled the restart valiantly. I mean, it's very reminiscent to the Rock Prime restart. It's kind of interesting. We've seen a lot of wild stuff happen so far. But what are you ultimately working on? We're looking at the last 20 minutes here. What is your kind of exit strategy here?
The main plan is just get enough ambitions done. I'm going to do some of the last quest, but I need to get my settlement to attack to get my ambition done, and then hopefully like, get my banner done. And after that, this sell the thing off. I'm just hoping I can win just maybe renown and levels. I got a lot of levels, and I'm hoping that'll counterbalance those 4 points I lost. Ooh, nice shot. But yeah, you know. I'm just really hoping, you know, I could pull this off.
Speaking of nice shots, how about that archer? How's he been doing for you?
I barely ever use archers, but, you know, this is making me rethink. This archer has been taking some pretty nice shots.
Oh, dude.
I've been really, really enjoying this archer.
There's been a lot of amazing showings with the archers today, so definitely, definitely great. It's definitely great to see, honestly. So, anyways.
Yeah, super swell.
Yeah, man. So with that being said, man, good luck with the rest of the tournament. Good job. I mean, you really are coming back with some vengeance, so that's awesome. And we will see you at the end. Just remember, 20 minutes left.
Thanks, man.
Yep. All right, man, what a deal. What a deal. And then we have ourselves Kin Gang going in at the tournament right now. That is huge. We got fights across the board, but... Oh, no!
Uh-oh.
Oh, no!
Uh-oh.
Oh, no. This is, like, the worst-case scenario. Well, he's going after the right enemy. If he can kill him, he can change this fight. He's just got to kill that big bastard in the middle. Oh, boy, I'm worried about the guy on the other side there. Oh, no.
Get him.
Okay, so now this is where it gets interesting, though. Oh no, he's gonna move. If he eats that, it's over. I mean, he almost would have been better throwing the archer right in at him, because this is. Oh man. Oh, and he doesn't have a weapon. He doesn't.
Oh no.
So okay, the one's running. My goodness. I gotta imagine he's not gonna win this fight. He's just skipping his turn. I mean, even if you can just punch him, you gotta do it. You know. Gosh, yeah. So we're gonna call. I'm gonna look in on some of these other guys here, because I imagine this is gonna end nasty. Well, maybe he
can still pull it out.
It's, no, he can't. All right, so that's unfortunate. That's you have yourself the end coming for him there with that. That's really unfortunate. But that's what you risk with the arena. I want to say Destiny Orange just went straight into a barbarian camp, wrecked face, ended up with a bunch of good stuff. He did actually kill a Reaver on top of that, so that's really impressive. Day 15 killing Reavers. Very good. What else do we have? We have ourselves Forant in this big battle. I really want to get this interview done with him. We're at 15 minutes out, so here's hoping. I accidentally jumped on Medieval Cyborg. I don't know why I unmuted him by accident. So we'll have to, so that's been discarded, but... Forant just going ham. I don't want to wreck his concentration, because he is in this. He is definitely in this for sure. So
he got that piked break with a nice face shot. That was huge.
Yep. Oh, and then that kill right there. This is, once they start running, we'll pull up, because he's just going to be killing them anyways. I just want to make sure that I don't want to distract him. That's one of the worst things that could probably happen here. If something was to go wrong, you misclick, whatever the deal is. Can't be responsible for that, but, is what it is. If you guys are still watching this, and you could, take a second, hit that like, hit the subscribe button for more content just like this. There's a lot of stuff on the channel, of course. A lot of different Battle Brothers content, top 5 named weapons of the week, stuff like that, perk guides, and etc. So it'll be really good for you. Alright, so with that, now that he is freed up, we can unlock the Forant. The floor ant. Hey, floor ant. How's it going, man? Let's get your, what's going on? How's this thing working for you? How's this tournament been for you? He's a shy dog. Your mic is muted if you... He's not. Oh, there he is.
The first minute of the game, I kind of died, so that was fun.
Only kind of, huh?
Yeah, man, we saw.
No, it was funny. I was, like, laughing my ass off. I was like, oh, God. I should have ran.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think, but it really seems like you've come back a lot stronger, of course, and you got yourself some more brothers here across the board. How are you feeling about your restart right now?
Yeah, decent. I mean, I got my step over here.
Mm-hmm. Huh? Well, that's good. I mean,
no.
Shinobi, you got anything for him, or?
No, man. Head up. Keep slogging away at it.
Well, we got...
time is left.
Yeah,
we have no idea.
We have 12 minutes left, so make sure you're get those crowns situated, get rid of your stuff, and make it happen. But otherwise, man, good job thus far. Even though you went down, there's a huge turnaround, of course, with this fight, this competition. I think it's definitely going to work in your favor when it's all said and done. So, yeah, good job. Good job coming back.
Yeah, and by the way, guys, he did just reinstall this for the tournament.
I was going to bring that up, yeah.
In a couple months.
Oh, man. It's crazy. It's a good time, though, so... All right, man. Well, we'll talk to you in about 11 minutes here.
Ready?
All right, man. Cool.
You know, man, the Beast Slayer's run, I didn't see cracking up to be this exciting. I was really imagining that we were just going to see a lot of missed arrow shots, some Beast Slayers die right off the bat, and then basically a peasant militia without the numbers.
Yeah, I mean, they've all... Yeah, go ahead.
I've been pleasantly surprised.
Yeah. I feel like it's very, like, they've all been very competitive. That's the big thing. We had two losses right in the beginning. You thought, man, this could go downhill. We almost had a close loss, I believe, with Kin Gang. I think he was close. There was a fight that got a little hairy, but he came back. Yeah, it's just the consistency is key, being able to establish your group. Since they've all established, now the points are being thrown all over the place. I thought we were going to lose, maybe it was it Kin Gang with all them dire... No, it was Forant. He ended up taking on all them direwolves. And so that's a whole nother deal in itself. But it's, yeah.
To me, this match has been... You know, with the Gordon Comstock, we saw a blowout. We saw a bunch of home runs hit. It wasn't even competitive at the final scoring. This game has been more like a pitcher's duel. You have to see the intricacies. You have to really look at the details if you want to figure out who's ahead in the end.
Yeah. And I have noticed, like, I know just based on the last tournament, people loved that everybody was scratching by... dying left and right and stuff, or just almost wiping their whole party and whatnot for that suspense of who's going to win. The fact that everybody came down to a complete draw, that will not happen in this one. 100%. You can definitely tell that. Especially when you lose one guy completely, you don't get all those stats. It's unfortunate, but that happens. So we're riding high on this one. This is definitely a NASCAR type of thing. Sometimes it becomes a slow burn, but at the end of the day, if there's a wreck, you don't want to miss out. So it's just how it is, you know. But it's funny to me because you have Destiny Orange and Forant in the north taking on these barbarians. I'm very surprised that they didn't end up going south. Kind of like Soberjan was talking about with Destiny Orange, about how he thought for sure, and because he was on the trajectory of going south, but he ends up going back north. Those arena fights are huge. It's a game changer, and it has so far. It has been. If you're the only guy, which it won't happen in this tournament, but we have ourselves Kin Gang going in losing three guys, which I imagine were probably his best guys, which is a huge blow. But if he establishes those points, or even takes, if he wins two tournaments, he takes away those three points, and that is big. When it comes to Medieval Cyborg, because I think he might not be the fastest and stuff, but he's doing things methodically. I think we'll be surprised. He might be the new oh man, what's his name? The competitor that was, we didn't know that he was going to do much, but he ended up doing a, like, I've talked about him, Sherbert, yeah. So Sherbert's one of those guys that, man, it just didn't seem like it was going to go anywhere, but it ended up going, it brought him to second place, and that's, what more can you ask for? He didn't have negative four points. You know, he doesn't have negative 4 points. Sherbert didn't have negative 4 points, and here we are again. You know, looking at Medieval Cyborg, it's just, it is what it is. We'll have to see.
You know, the way that this guy has just been plodding along, head down, fight after fight, doing like Gordon Comstock, don't kill everything, just kill what pays. I think it's been a big key to Cyborg's game.
Right. Right, right, right. Yeah, just kind of looking at it right now. We got a lot of barbarian fights. It looks like Medieval Cyborg did make his way north. He does have his big group. He's probably got some more levels now. Man, I don't know. So let's kind of make our predictions. Let's kind of throw some predictions out. We are coming to the end here. We got 8 minutes left. Who are you looking at as a front runner right now? Shinobi? Well, I don't know where Shinobi is at the moment, but I will say for me, in terms of where we're at, I'm looking at, man, it's tough. I feel,
you know,
like,
I gotta go with Destiny. Oh. Like, Destiny Orange is just, I think he's gonna clinch it, even with that negative 4 points. I could be wrong. I could be surprised.
Yeah, I'm just, it's tough because I have to keep the realistic thought that there are 4 points missing. I think that Medieval Cyborg might come away with this, as crazy as it might sound. And the reason, though, either that, Kin Gang would be a good one. The problem is you're looking at negative 4 points on the two guys on the top. You have Medieval Cyborg as the only guy solidifying 3 points. He is not negative 4. The guys on the top are, and they haven't taken advantage of those 4 points that might matter the most. He has traveled all over the place. He has probably the days. He's got all these different metrics that may be just thrown off to the wayside because he doesn't have all the kills or he doesn't have all the, you know, whatever the case may be. But he's got so many other metrics and one to himself. I don't know. For me, I feel like that's the difference maker in this tournament.
He is. He's spreading out the points quite nicely. He's going to have to clinch second in a few of those key ones that these other three guys are fighting for, though, I think, if he's going to be at the top of the pack.
Yeah, well, it's a spread. It's a spread. We've seen it with Bravo Wolf in the last tournament. Bravo. Exactly. Yeah, he did all the other things. He did all the other things, and I think that falls through the cracks when you end up doing the scoring and stuff, that maybe they're not as effective. No, it's definitely effective. Guys, we designed these points so that way you had a chance, even if things go south on you, you have a chance to still make the days, get more brothers. The thing is, you have two sides of this argument. You have the guys who, if you start over, you get an arena win, you check the map, what are some of the ones? Maybe complete ambitions, do some of the, you know, get your money to stack up just same way that Bravo Wolf did. You have all these different areas where you don't have to be the most efficient killer. But for efficient killers, you have levels, you have more brothers, I'm assuming. You can get the crowns, and you definitely get the kills. So, yeah, it's just interesting. This is an interesting fight going on right now. Destiny Orange is testing his men by going against Reavers, and let me tell you what. An AoE, this could get really, really ugly.
This could get really ugly.
Really ugly.
And he is stacking it up for them to get ugly perfectly.
Come on, headshots.
No, that's still a good hit.
Yeah, I will say too, with Kin Gang, I could see him winning it all. You know, I think he's there too. I think it becomes the two at the bottom and the fight at the top. These guys, I don't know. It's tough, man. There's a lot of, it's a whirlpool right now. There's a lot of options. There's a lot of ways. Unfortunately, though, if you think about it, nobody's really, and Medieval Cyborg is the only guy right now who's getting ready to sell off everything. We have 3 minutes left. So, And like I say, Destiny Orange is in the middle of a fight. So it's... This is where I'm saying. I really think that Medieval Cyborg has done all that he needs to win these metrics. Or a great deal of the metrics. And he's not against the gun. That's the biggest thing. He is not against the gun. He literally... All he's doing is... He's still pulling things off his brothers, and he's got his crowns where it is. It's unreal.
I know. It would be really wise for him at this point to invest in a retinue to just guarantee those 2 points, because I bet he's still going to be competitive in gold.
Yeah, if he has, depending on the retinue, for sure, he'll be fine there.
Ooh. Look at Forrest's map. He has been covering ground.
Yeah, he's trying to hit these metrics as quickly as he can. Can't say I blame him. I just hope he doesn't get into a fight, but at the same time, he does have a boatload of crown. What's that?
He does. We got to tell these guys that their time is winding down.
They know. They hopefully they know. I guess we do usually do that, huh? What the heck am I thinking? All right.
Oh, no.
Well, there's time.
No, King Aang just got ambushed.
Oh, hang on.
With a bunch of naked boys.
Hang on. All right, guys, we got, let's see here. We got 3 minutes left. All right. Now you can go ahead about your thing. Now everybody knows that King Gang's in a situation. Sorry. Yeah, yep.
Oh man, and he's just dancing out of it. Holy cow.
Yeah, he'll make it out of there. Yeah, just I don't know why I didn't tell him sooner about that. I don't know why.
I didn't know you were unmuting.
Yeah, well, I just had to tell him quick. So, well, it is what it is. That's fine. It's not going to make a big difference. 3 minutes left. It's no real strategy they can overcome besides selling everything as quickly as possible. And really, I think Destiny Orange is starting to feel the repercussions of this. He's got to get this kill quick. I mean, quick. He's got to get this kill quick. It's coming down to the wire here.
There it is.
Yep. Now, he's got what looks like a little over a minute. I said 3 minutes left. I will give him... I'll make it fair and give them a few... more seconds. That was on me, guys. I don't know why I didn't tell them. I've been telling everybody.
Evil Puggo came out just like, if they die, they die.
If he dies, he dies. Yeah, right. But I'll give him a chance here to get this stuff done. I'll give him the extra minute here even. So they have 1 minute left. Technically, the tournament should end right now. I'll give him the extra minute here to get everything. So, but to be fair, guys, when you do join this tournament, you should really have a timer next to you. You should not be waiting on us to tell you, because you should, if you know 5 minutes left, you can sell all your equipment and do the original strategy thanks to what's his face? I can't think of his name. The other, Yager Plays was the original one who came up with that, like, hey, 5 minutes left, I'm just going to sit there, I'm going to have just my food left, everything sold, and kind of just burn those days. Yep.
Let the days pass by.
Yeah, and I do notice this Kin Gang just passed Medieval Cyborg in days. Oh my gosh. And he's not pushing days anymore. Medieval is just sitting there like, oh, I'm good. Oh my gosh, guys, that's nuts. All right, this is gonna do it here. All right, guys, I'm gonna have everybody pause right there. That is it. That is the tournament there. All right, guys, with that being said, we are gonna go to a quick break and then give you the winners.
Grandpa, can you tell me a story about 2020?
Ah, 2020. A story of adventure, brotherhood, and the purest love. I joined a mercenary band that year. Lost my foot to the diabetes, although people did think it was the linworm. Finally, I ended up mugging the love of my life.
Huh?
Yeah, I f***ed that melon so f***ing hard.
Oh my god!
Yep, the town was pissed, but I corked that melon something fierce, and I regret nothing.
Grandpa, what the f***?
All right, guys, the tallying is officially in. We have ourselves fourth through first place. Of course, we're going to hand this over to Redemption. Let us know who won this tournament.
So starting off, we're going to go from fourth to first. We have fourth place, King Aang, with a total of 3 points. Now, the 3 points was a little bit deceptive because he honestly was 1 point away from making a lot more points in multiple categories, but in the end, he only had one claim to fame, and that was his total number of days. He rocked the entire tournament in terms of how many days he reached at 34. However, again, because he's 1 point off it in multiple categories, he's still stuck there down at fourth place. Third place, coming in at 7 points, is Foran. Now, Foran actually had originally tallied up to 11 points. However, he had an unfortunate end early on in his run, which knocked him down 4 points, down to 7 points. However, Foran actually was pretty consistent. He had placed in almost every single category, at least got 1 point. He did stand out in the gold category. He was actually over 2,000 more gold than all the other contestants by the end of his run at 4,732. But otherwise, again, that minus four really hurt him. In fact, we'll jump over to second place. Coming at only 10 points is Destiny Orange. He also had a mishap early on that knocked him down 4 points, but really, it's like if one of these people survives, they could switch places here. So I wanted to highlight that. But Destiny Orange made it to second place with 10 points. He had a whopping 754 renown, which is incredible. He was placing high in most categories. His renown is probably the highest I've seen in this tournament so far. There might have been one other contestant who made it further. But yeah, he made a ton of points through that category. His kills, that's the other. He had 104 kills, which is insane, especially since he had to start over again after everyone else. Yeah, to make it 104 kills, he absolutely dominated that category. No one was even close. But yeah, it was incredible showing. These two players both had miserable ends early on, and they still came back and put up a good fight. But in the end, there has to be one winner, and that is Medieval Cyborg with a whopping 22 points. Now, Medieval, just even though I just want to put this out there, like, you don't have to get kills to be extremely successful in this game. He only had 53 kills, which was one above King Aang, and he still pulled off an over 10 point lead over the second place contender. He did great in days, getting second. Renown, he got second with 582. Number of brothers, he placed first. Levels, this was one that he actually stood out in. He had 39 levels, which is almost 10 points over the next highest. He managed to get, was the only one to get a very friendly relation. He was the only one to do an arena. He had the most settlements, good gold. He hit most of the categories, and that really just put him over the top. So your number one, or your first place candidate and overall best Battle Brothers performer today is Medieval Cyborg.
Holy cow.
Woo!
Hey, Puggo, you remember that conversation we had when we were wrapping the run-up?
Yes, I do. And thank All you, right. sir. I am feeling on top of the world with that one. Hey, listen, go ahead.
Like I said, if he clinches as many of these second place categories as he can, he's got it. And he did it. And hats off to him.
The only killer is how much was taken away from King Gang. It is unbelievable. But let's kind of segue into first place here, man. Medieval Cyborg, the man, the myth, the legend officially of the tournament, man. When I was watching your run here, I kept thinking to myself, like, he's doing everything. He's not a master of, you know, he's not a master of everything here, you know, or anything. It's just you kept the consistency on a high level. It wasn't about getting a bunch of brothers. It was about keeping guys alive, taking the battles that that mattered the most to your company. You traveled the map. When we got to 30-minute mark, or actually just past the third, when we got to your interview, you were at 20 days, and I was just thinking to myself, like, there is something to be said here. I even said in the first 30 minutes, I was like, this guy has, like, it's insane. Like, we didn't talk a lot about you in the beginning. But it's literally the definition of silent but deadly without the fart reference. So, yeah, it's it's definitely great.
Congratulations, Cyborg. Like, you approached your gameplay like you did your analytics. You knocked it out of the park.
Yeah, it was funny because, like, my objective coming in was to play safe and try to get second in every category, so it kind of worked out.
Oh, yeah,
I got to say, you might have out-Gordon Comstocked Gordon Comstock. I believe, correct me if I'm wrong here, I can't remember if he had 24 or 21 points.
Yeah, it was, I thought it was 21. I'd have to go
19.
Back and look at
it. I thought
it
was 21. But you might have took the Gordo crown from Gordo.
Yeah, you might have it, man. Well, how are you feeling about it, man? How do you feel about the whole tournament, like where you're at with it, and just clinching that first place on your second, you know, your second place bout that you were looking for?
All right, well, I mean, so I think my strategy going in was decent, but, like, it was kind of a perfect storm. Like, I literally didn't lose a single brother. Like, there were, like, times where, you know, Pike's about to hit someone, he might die, and it just misses, you know. It's, like a perfect, like, lucky run added onto that.
Yeah.
And, yeah, it was just a lot of fun.
That's awesome, man. Yeah, like I say, I think you handled your business very well. You did what needed to be done to win this competition. These guys behind you were in a fury of coming back with vengeance. It's really incredible. But yeah, like I say, great job, man. We're gonna do an update video at some point here where we talk about all the champions and stuff. And I definitely think there's a lot of records broken in this one. So congratulations.
I just want to put out there.
Yep.
Is Gordon Comstock, you guys were wondering how many points he had? He had 19.
Was
19.
It Rock Prime that had the highest?
Yeah, that's what I said.
I can look that up too. It should be right here.
Yeah. Who's our highest scoring champion so far?
It was a Rock Prime, I'm pretty sure.
I think it was Rock Prime. I thought the same thing. I thought
he had 21 with minus 4 points.
Rock Prime only had 17 points.
Okay.
So they tied.
So pretty much you breached 20 and you got the highest. 20. So hell yeah, that's crazy. All right, well, let's keep this train moving here. We're gonna go to second place then. Second place, we ended up having Destiny Orange. Dude, you want to talk about incredibly efficient in terms of getting kills, getting his bro. I mean, you had your loss. It really worked in your favor in some way that. When you started over, if you had survived that last or that fight in the very beginning and had to rework your guys to the top, it wouldn't have been nearly as efficient as being on your by your lonesome, you know, making all these kills and going to the top. You had 104 kills, dude. You broke it. You broke it. Like, you broke the record. Like, that is a shattered record, man. I don't know. There's so much to be said about your run, man. But how do you feel? And congratulations on second place.
I feel honestly a little bit disappointed. I don't know if I was even a 4-point difference. I can't remember. But yeah, it definitely is a bummer that I had to, you know, restart. I was really going for it. I was really trying to emphasize, you know, gaining the kills and gaining the levels, even though I guess was way off on levels, props to Cyborg, and gaining the renown. That's what I was really just, you know, I already lost. I just need to get first place in all these. Hope it pushed me, the ambitions and all that, honestly, wasn't enough. But yeah, I literally just threw myself at everything I could, you know. At this point, I need to get all these in order to even stand a chance. So I was just, you know, risking all, essentially.
Yeah. I think one of the big things when you go into these tournaments, guys, and this is something from home you guys can learn from this, joining in or watching guys play, it's a huge part of this is not just being the berserker out on the battlefield. It is efficient and it does matter. If you think about it, imagine doing an arena, getting kills, getting, you know, you're getting levels and you're getting brothers. That's four metrics, right? There has to be room for other metrics to really to make you outshine the competition. Now, you take away that negative 4 points, you're sitting, correct me if I'm wrong, you're at 17 points. Is that correct, Redemption?
Click the wrong one. He said you would be sitting at 14.
14. Okay, so I was thinking 13. I don't know where we brought 13. So. I thought I heard 13, but either way, that's still like that does bump that up just a little bit. But there were so many close calls where the point system was so close that you just slipped down to that second place, or you get first, but you get first in a category, but then you get third. It's wild. I don't know. Shinobi, you want to add something to that, or?
Yeah, you know, I gotta say, you guys all had a decent amount of gold, and nobody went after retinue member. You know, I really think that would have helped shift the scales in somebody's favor, at least, banking that 2,500 gold or 2,000 gold. What is it, 2,500 for the scavenger?
What was that, Destiny?
I had a quiver camp follower.
Oh, you did? Did you?
I did. Okay. Yes.
Well, either way, God, in terms of your performance, though, I think that honestly, man, we looked at you and said, I mean, this guy is steamrolling. He's doing his thing. It is honestly very surprising to hear where the points ended up leading, but. That's just how it goes. You know what I mean? This is something you can look back on, learn from it, and then get back in the tournament and start whooping. Because that's you clearly got the skill, and whether luck or not, you did a great job, man.
I definitely learned from this. I definitely learned from this that kills aren't everything. I'll have to take some advice from Cyber, maybe focus a little bit more on other things.
Mm-hmm. You gotta spread the love around.
For sure. So third place ended up being Forant. You were in the same exact boat as Destiny Orange. You went out right off the beginning. It was an unfortunate event, but you came back in and you were so efficient, just getting everything you were just doing everything in your power to excel this process, and I think you did a great job in doing so. One of the things that did get a little nail biter was you did end up coming across more dire wolves later on. They killed a few of your brothers. I think it was like three of your brothers. That was really, that was a nail biter. It was hard to walk away from. But you still ended up coming out. Maybe it wasn't exactly the run you wanted, but maybe it's the run you needed for future endeavors. How are you feeling about that?
Eh. I mean, at least I didn't come in last. That's all I wanted to do.
Throwing that salt around.
Oh, goodness. When I reinstalled the game, I just didn't. I didn't prepare for any of this, so I was. There was like no plan. No.
I reached out to Forant literally 2 days ago, if that. Maybe it was yesterday, and was like, "Hey, man, we need a fourth. You're my guy. Like, help me out." And he's like, "Sure, I'll reinstall. I got your back."
I literally forgot about the whole thing until today. I woke up this morning, I'm like, oh yeah, aren't I supposed to do a tournament today?
Oh my gosh, this guy.
Yeah, this guy.
Well, this is why we need more people to join in, be a part of it. We do have guys that want to, it just the time frame doesn't work out for them today. But we are definitely trying to make this work as best we can. But Forant, I do appreciate you coming in and doing this last second, of course, but also great job. I know we're, for what it's worth, You had a hell of a comeback, and it was definitely fun to watch.
I hope I can come back, maybe if I remember about the next tournament.
Oh my gosh. All right. Well,
get him out of here. Get the hook.
Yeah.
Pull him off the stage.
Yeah. All right. Well, then we'll go into the last guy here, fourth place, Kin Gang. Now, I got to say, guys, maybe he wasn't the fastest of the punch. Maybe he didn't do everything that needed to be done, at least for the metrics, because it was a doggy dog competition. I mean, it was very competitive, irregardless of what happened, not going out within the first 3 minutes and still staying consistent across the board. It's really unfortunate, because when you look at the numbers, you fell out of so many categories by nothing. And you even stole categories. You stole the category of days last second. Mind you, I was watching it at the very end. I'm like, oh my gosh, You know, he just stole days because Medieval Cyborg had stopped rolling through days, and you literally passed him at the last second, which was pretty spectacular to watch. But I think the number one thing from your run that can be that is most personified, it would be your Master Archer. Dude, holy crap. it was a great showing across, regardless of what happened. It was a great showing. I'm still gonna say congratulations, even if you are in fourth, because I thought you did a lot. You showed a lot, and maybe you just put a little more fury behind your punch. You know what I'm saying? But otherwise, really good job, man.
And I gotta say, King Gang, when you go back and watch this, you're gonna hear how excited you had us through most of the tournament, and then you're gonna hear our heartbreak when you went into that arena fight.
Oh yeah.
Like you took us on a ride, buddy, and we were with you the whole way. I just want you to know that.
Thank you. It's the arena fight is something I normally would have saved scum at this point in the game, and I figured, what the hell, I'm down here, might as well give it a shot. Did not work out as planned, so I just tried to edge out at least days as much as I could.
Yeah,
honestly, this was really fun.
Oh, dude,
even with that failure, it was like, I was doing so well. I spent 30 minutes on one massive fight with a horde of undead.
That's right. And that probably was, you know, honestly, that was probably the biggest hindrance, because you were in that fight forever.
And you got maybe 2 kills out of the deal.
No, I got a fair amount of kills. I just...
No, the kills came from the militiamen, which I didn't count since it wasn't from you.
I still ended up with, like, one guy had 6 kills from that fight alone.
Yeah, but those were resurrected, so that doesn't count.
Ah, fair enough.
Yeah, it's an unfortunate situation, but at the same time, like, Bravo Wolf ended up having that near same fight. It was less zombies, of course, but it was still a very good strategy to pull those guys in. I wouldn't want to take that on by my lonesome and those brothers that you had at the time. So, either way, great job. Great job to everybody. This was a very good tournament. Very, very competitive. Even if the score doesn't show at the very end, it was a very competitive tournament. I think you guys could have gone into other tournaments and even put a good enough showing for second and maybe even first. With that being said, we're going to open up the floor, guys. Any thoughts on the tournament? Anything you want to add or kind of go from there?
I guess I'll speak since someone else is. I gotta say, I found this like last week. Joined the Discord and did some practice runs, and honestly, this was just really fun to go through.
I definitely love because I've been doing a couple practice tourneys. I was really gearing up for this, so I feel like, you know, since I did those practice tourneys, kind of got me, like, you know, edged in, because, you know, in a way it kind of feels like, you know, you don't feel nearly as pressure because you like feel comfortable. This is comfortable to me, so I definitely gotta thank you for, you know, hosting this tournament, hosting the practice tourney, Shinobi. And, you know, just making this, you know, the Battle Brothers community unite, kind of.
Yeah. Yeah, that's definitely the goal. That's a huge part of this, is getting guys together, expanding the world of Battle Brothers. And I think we can definitely do that. And down the road, especially as there's winners, there's losers, and there's the comeback kid, we'll be watching for all of it. Any other final thoughts, guys?
Oh, can I talk about...
man, there's no losers in this.
Right.
I feel like I probably could have, like, played a bit before this. I think I did, like, just slightly, but then I was like, eh.
I don't know.
Well, you got on this morning and started playing for a while before you went back to For Honor.
I probably...
Thrash game.
All right.
I think you were talking about something that you didn't like about the tournament.
Yeah, it just felt too quiet. But that's
The one thing I would say is I feel like the arena should be lowered in points. But I feel like based on how lucky you get, like, you know, someone might get a bunch of gladiators, but someone might get 3 nachos, and for 3 points, you know, I feel like it's a little bit too luck based.
Hey, but that's
getting the nachos, that was awful.
Yeah, but but here's the thing with the arena. Keep in perspective too that this is the risk of 3 points. If you get it, you're you know, who knows where it can go for you, right? Not everybody's going to be going after it, but if you do end up getting it and you deserved it, right, you can choose to say yes or no. If it's nachos, you don't want to face nachos, you can always wait a day, come back, and if it's hyenas or two dire, whatever it is, you know, you can take that on. Well, but we are going to have runs where gladiators, you know, or hedge knights or whatever the case is, and people are going to want to, you know, get those points. And obviously that helped out huge, and it might have made a big difference too for King Gang, because if he hadn't lost those three brothers and he got those, you know, he would have tied out with Medieval giving him three extra points. That could make a big difference, let alone kills, levels, and brothers. So there's a lot that happened at the towards the last 15 minutes with King Gang that pulled him farther down in the tournament.
And I gotta say, with the arena, the metric, the 3-2-1, like, if so, if Medieval Cyborg hadn't gone down and touched the arena at all, right, Destiny, and mm-hmm. you hadn't had your restart, you guys would have tied at 18, and then it would have come down to your retirement score for the tiebreaker. So if you would have went down, got one arena fight in, you'd have been right back in the running.
Right. Well, and if King Gang didn't lose some of those brothers that right. he had and all that, there's a lot of things that ended up changing. I think it just shows what can happen, how much things can dramatically change. But
honestly, yeah. though, I wouldn't consider this a loss on my part, because I got to sit through some amazing battles and come out more or less unscathed from things that could have absolutely destroyed me. Yeah, the fact fair. That I pushed my luck too far kind of... that was on me, less on anything else.
I never really realized how... I didn't really think my cannon fodder was that important. When I went like, looking back, I probably could have used the levels for more points.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure. Alright, well, any final thoughts? Otherwise, we'll call it.
I do want to say, like, I had a pretty good run, obviously, but I wasn't at all confident going in, so I want to say, like, to anyone who is too nervous to compete, that they should just do it, even if they don't do well. There's no shame in that.
Right on.
If I could get a chance, I'd like to congratulate everyone and say, hey, this was a great thing, and I'm looking forward to future tournaments.
Right on. Oh, yeah, and there will be, and we will get even more extravagant. It'll be great. All right, guys. Well, with that being said, don't forget to like, subscribe, join the Discord so we can talk to you and also have you join these tournaments, of course. So I will see you in the next one. Bye.